I'll call the committee meeting to order. To make it easier for residents to voice their comments, there will be two public comment periods. There will be one at the beginning of the meeting designated for comments related to items on the agenda, and one at the end of the meeting for general public comment. Speakers will be limited to 3 minutes to state their comments. This meeting is being video recorded and streamed live on the internet. Mr. Hill, please confirm posting and roll call.
Mayor, this meeting has been posted in accordance with the Nevada Open Meeting Law. All members of the council are present, and you have a quorum.
Thank you. Mr. Derrick, oh no. Now is the time for the first public comment. If you wish to make a public comment, please come to the podium, speak directly into the mic, state your name and zip code, and you will have 3 minutes to speak. Seeing no one, we'll close the public hearing. Mr. Derrick, are there any changes to the agenda?
I do have one change, Your Honor. Items 6 and 7 will be heard together for a brief presentation, but voted on separately. And that is your only change.
Thank you. May I have a motion? Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion, Member Councilman Stewart, and that motion carries.
Item number one is Bill number 3704, ZCA-200-766-0008-A8, zone change amendment for a drive-through car wash. Your recommendation is to refer to regular meeting.
Ms. Corrado?
Mayor and members of council, this item is the ordinance for the amendment to a planned unit development for a drive-through car wash that was approved at your May 2nd meeting.
Council, do you have any questions or comments? May I have a motion? Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilman Stewart. That motion carries.
Item number two is Bill number 3715, ZCA-202-201-1743, zone change for El Dorado Valley Master Plan, WDA El Dorado Valley. Your recommendation is to refer to regular meeting.
Mayor and members of council, this item is the ordinance to establish the El Dorado Valley Master Plan that was approved at your May 2nd meeting.
Any questions or comments? May I have a motion? I'll
move.
Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilman Seabock, and that motion carries.
Item number three is Bill number 3716, ZCA-200-966-0018-A11, zone change amendment for Inspirata Station. Your recommendation is to refer to regular meeting.
Mayor and members of council, this item is the ordinance for the amendment to remove 3.8 acres from the West Henderson Global Business District Master Plan that was approved at your May 2nd meeting.
Thank you. Any questions or comments? If not, may I have a motion? Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilman Shaw, that motion carries.
Item number four is Bill number 3717, ZCA-201-8000-276-A14, zone change amendment for Inspirata Station. Your recommendation is to refer to regular meeting.
Mayor and members of council, this item is the ordinance for the amendment to add those 3.8 acres to the Inspirata Town Center Master Plan that was approved at your May 2nd meeting.
Thank you. Any questions or comments? Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilman Stewart. That motion carries.
Item number five is Bill number 3718, ZCA-200-666-0018-A31, zone change amendment for McDonald Highlands. Your recommendation is to refer to regular meeting.
Mayor and members of council, this item is the ordinance for the amendment to McDonald Highlands Master Plan that was approved at your May 2nd meeting.
Any questions? May I have a motion? Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilwoman Cox, and the motion carries.
As a reminder, items 6 and 7 will be heard together but voted on separately. Item 6 is Bill number 3719. ZOA-202-301-2526 for a marijuana dispensary update. And item number 7 is Bill number 3720, amend Henderson Municipal Code section 4.118.070, conditions applying to specific retail marijuana, location business types, and section 4.118.200, delivery off premises. Your recommendation is for items 6 and 7 to refer to the regular meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Cathcart. Thank you for joining us today.
No problem. Thank you, Mayor and Council. For the record, Mike Cathcart representing the Finance Department. Item number seven is making changes to Henderson Municipal Code 4.118 to do three things. First, this update makes conforming changes for the rules of delivery of cannabis. This activity has been authorized under HMC 4.116, the medical cannabis chapter, and HMC 4.05, which establishes fees for these business activities. City Council adopted the fees for delivery approximately 2 years ago, and this addition to 4.118 was scheduled to be heard shortly after. However, this item has been delayed several times. In the time in between, the rules for delivery under the medical chapter have been utilized for compliance. Second, it adds curbside delivery options to the Henderson Municipal Code as this is an allowable activity under Nevada revised statutes and was passed by the Nevada legislature in 2021 as an allowable activity. Curbside delivery is subject to Title 19 community development approval. Additionally, our police department will be able to review operating procedures for safety purposes. The third and final part of this update is the only new policy in this proposal and would remove the co-location requirement for a medical and adult use cannabis establishment. The state of Nevada issued 6 provisional certificates for Henderson for adult use locations in December 2018. Because of the co-location requirement and no additional medical cannabis establishment licenses, the city has not moved forward with allowing these 6 to apply for a conditional use permit or business license. The change in this proposal would eliminate the requirement for co-location of medical and adult use establishments, thus allowing the 6 new adult use applicants to move forward in the process, and it would cap the number of cannabis sales establishments to 11. These potential establishments are subject to zoning approval and Title 19 separation requirements, and with the current 5 locations and the additional 6, there would be no future applicants unless the City Council revisits the cap of 11 in the future. And just a final thing, I believe Brian Gordon from Applied Analysis is here. I believe all of you were briefed on a study that was commissioned by the industry, so he is here as well for any questions. And then Mr. Dichter is going to talk about the Title 19 changes.
Good afternoon. Eddie Dichter with the Community Development and Services. I'll keep mine a little shorter because he read all the details. To coincide with the Title 4 changes, we're recommending changes to Title 19, the development code for retail marijuana dispensary, to remove the requirement for co-location with medical and retail, so that will no longer be required. In addition, we are changing the code to no longer allow any waivers from the distance separation between dispensaries. That's 5,280 feet. That will no longer be an option for to be waived. Just so for the record, all of our other separations are also not allowed to be waived. So any marijuana location coming in would have to comply with all of our code requirements and not allow any waivers to distance separations. Other than that we're here to answer any questions.
Thank you. Council, any questions or comments?
Are the 5 that currently have medical, are they required to maintain medical or can they do away with medical?
They would not be required to keep it if we took the co-location out. They are currently co-located, but I think that would be a business decision for those establishments on whether they kept the medical or not.
Okay.
They have a motion?
I'll move.
Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilman Seebach, and that motion carries.
And then for item 7, please, may I have a motion? Please vote.
And all members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilman Seebach, and that motion carries.
Your next item is number 8, Bill number 3721, creating local improvement district T22, LID T22, for Rainbow Canyon Phase 2. Your recommendation is to refer to regular meeting.
Mr. Olson.
Hi there. Yes, as mentioned, this is an ordinance to create the local improvement district T22 and Rainbow Canyon Phase 2. This is 234 acres on the north shore of Lake Las Vegas. So recommend move to regular meeting.
Thank you. Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilman Stewart, and that motion carries.
Item number 9 is Bill number 3722, assessing the cost of local improvements in LID number 222 against accessible properties benefited. LID T22 Rainbow Canyon Phase 2. Your recommendation is refer to regular meeting.
Thank you. May I have a motion? Unless there are any questions? You don't have any. Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion made by Councilwoman Cox, and that motion carries.
Item number 10 is Bill number 3723, authorizing the issuance and sale of bonds for LID T22 Rainbow Canyon Phase 2. Your recommendation is to refer to a regular meeting.
Do you have anything to add?
Just that the bond sales, $19,485,000 for those improvements that will be assessed to those properties there on the North Shore.
Thank you. May I have a motion? Please vote.
All members voting in favor of the motion by Councilman Stewart, and that motion carries.
Now is the time for our final public comment. If you wish to make a public comment, please come to the podium, speak directly into the mic, state your name and zip code, and you will have 3 minutes to speak. Seeing no one, I will adjourn the committee meeting at this time, and the regular meeting will begin at 4 o'clock.